Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon.
Welcome, just raise it up a little bit. Welcome to the 2023 Faith Works Christmas Concert. So glad to see you all here today. How many of you have been here before? Oh, look at that, excellent. How many of you have never been here? How many are just lying?
Half the class.
There's usually one or two in here. Well, we have an absolutely amazing afternoon of entertainment for you folks. As you can see up here, we just have world-class musicians and singers and entertainers, and you're going to be meeting them all as the afternoon goes on. I'd also like to point out some very special guests in our audience tonight. We have Archbishop Fred Hiltz right here. He's going to be giving us a keynote address later on, so we're very happy to have the Archbishop here. And the Sisters of St. John the Divine. There they are. Not just any St. John, you're the divine ones. Well, to start off our afternoon, I'd like to read our land acknowledgement. Today, we honor and acknowledge that this land and locality are on the historically traditional lands of the indigenous people of what we call Turtle Island and what is commonly known as North America. We acknowledge the leadership of indigenous elders who continue to teach us about what it means to live in a balanced and good way with all creation. May our time of worship together be blessed as we give respect to the first peoples of this land and seek to live in right relationship with ourselves, the Creator, and one another. We pray that the Spirit will lead us all into truth, into repentance for the wrongs of the past, and to true reconciliation with our Indigenous brothers and sisters, that we may be partners in healing and peace to the glory and thanksgiving of God, our Creator. Well, I'll tell you, we're going to start the entertainment. Oh, first I have to say that was a lovely song you just heard. It was called Wizards in Winter by Alexandra Weiss. It was a different song. Oh, you're playing that now? Oh, all right then. I was listening. I'm going to think, that song sounds familiar to me, but I know by another name. Okay, well, first off, allow me to present the marvelous Alexandra Weiss on keyboard and Newton Walker on percussion.
Thank you.
Alexandra Weiss and Newton Walker. That was amazing. I'm so glad you played that and not I didn't have to. That was an amazing piece. I could see the smoke coming up from your fingers. That was amazing. Okay, I'm going to head over there and do a song myself at the moment, but I'll tell you a little story about it just before we start. A number of years ago, I was one of the performers here for the one of the early concerts, and I decided I would do a comedy number for the crowd, and I had something called I Hope My Suit Still Fits This Christmas When I Get Out of Jail on Christmas Eve. And my wife heard me down in the basement rehearsing it. She said, "You can't sing that in an Anglican church." So I quickly threw together another idea, which I premiered here about 5 or 6 years ago, and so I'll be doing it again tonight, actually in honor of the sisters. December winds are howling, the snow will soon be here. There's not too much to recommend this time of year. But churches will be booming on the 24th, you'll see. I just pray they've reinforced their structural integrity. I hope the roof does not cave in this winter when I show up in church on Christmas Eve. Some people go more than once a year or so, but getting up on Sunday morning's not that easy to achieve. I'd really rather not be struck by lightning. So for one night I ask for a reprieve. The baby in the manger will be shouting, "Who's that stranger?" when I show up in church on Christmas Eve. Most Christmas carols, and I could listen to them all year long. I anxiously await the day when Christmas music starts to play in every store till I remember it's only mid-September, Christmas Eve, it seems like for a moment. Peace on earth is easy to achieve. The shepherds in the fields abiding will be asking me where I've been hiding when I show up in church on Christmas Eve. So if your ceiling does collapse this Christmas, I hope your broker won't deny the claim. Caused by snow, could be termites down below, or maybe it's that high note in a holy night that we should blame. Well, I bet right now you're starting to feel nervous, but if I'm wrong, I sure will be relieved. So light the tree and sing a carol and hope your pew is not in peril when I show up in church on Christmas Eve. Perhaps I'll have to drag my keister back here again in time for Easter, but right now I'll see you Christmas Eve. I really want to see you Christmas Eve, because this year we're using name tags. Well, I'll do one more little short one before I move the mic back over there and bring on our next act. This one is because I was playing an event a couple of weeks ago and somebody came up to me and asked if I was going to be doing a specific Christmas song they wanted called God Rest You, Jerry Mentlemen. And I thought I misheard and I asked him to repeat it. He said, "God Bless You, Jerry Mentlemen." I thought, this guy obviously had some kind of a spoonerism going on. So I thought, Jerry Mentlemen sounds like the name of a dentist. And so I went backstage and when we came out after intermission, I had this little song to sing for my Christmas crowd. God bless you, Jerry Mentlemen, the dentist you should see, from Halloween to Hanukkah to fix your cavity. But on December 25th, it's time for him to flee, So he flies to Arizona for a rest. I think that it's best that he goes to Arizona for a rest. Dr. Jerry Mentlemen, whenever I'm in pain, he uses skills in dentistry to fix my teeth again. But when the snow starts falling, he will hop onto a plane, and he'll spend the whole winter in the south instead of your mouth. Yes, it's better he's relaxing way down south. Well, I go to Dr. Mentlemen because he is the best. But when he's got the drill in hand, I pray he's not too stressed, because dentist rates of suicide are higher than the rest. And it wouldn't give me comfort and joy. Boy, oh boy, no, I'd never sit with comfort and joy. I'm just going to pop this out so I can walk over. Well, now the real singers are coming up. We have some amazing talent here today. And first up on our list is a woman who I've been listening to for many years. You don't realize I've been following her. The amazing Denise Williams. We are doing... Thank you. At least one of us is on the program. Okay, you all get to sing first. I'm going back to the piano. You can use this here. It's fine. Okay. Who's playing? Me or you? Am I playing? Oh, you're playing. I am EMC. Okay, we're all going to join in singing. It's in your program. If you will open up on the inside page, you will see God, Angels We Have Heard on High. So let's all join in singing Angels We Have Heard on High.
And going there.
All right. Can you hear me okay now? All right. Okay, now we're going to go into some beautiful, beautiful music. The lovely and talented Denise Williams is with us today, as you've already heard her singing. Denise, for those who haven't read their programs yet or don't already know her amazing work, is a 30-year veteran of the concert, opera, and theater stage and has performed with the Toronto Symphony Orchestra, Toronto Mendelssohn Choir, Mervish Productions, and literally dozens and dozens of others. She will be accompanied today by Ben MacDonald, who is an amazing multi-instrumentalist and performer, who will be on flute now and I believe saxophone later. So this guy's awesome. I want to see you play both at the same time. That's multi-instrumental. And on piano, we have the wonderful Toronto pianist, organist, and vocal coach, Mr. David Smith, who is also a bishop in the Anglo-Catholic Church. That's kind of cool. So which pays better, musician or...
So I know. Neither.
Have I been wasting my time, is what I'm wondering? Okay, and they have some beautiful songs for us tonight, so this afternoon, so please put your hands together for the wonderful Denise.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, and I'm very honored and delighted to be here. What you just heard was a lute carol by an American composer, female composer, Mary E. Caldwell, as in your programs. I was accompanied by David, and this person here on the flute is my son, Ben. Thought I'd say that. He was thinking he might get out of here before I say that, but I thought I would say it right off the bat. I'm very proud of him. Yes, it's a wonderful Christmas carol. I had to put it away for a number of years because it was one of the first ones I sang when I started taking lessons when I was 18 years old. And it was a very difficult song. But I just love this song, and I was very happy to bring it back. And before you were born, well, actually younger than you, I was starting this song. All right. All right, of course. Our next selection is Maria Wiegenlied, and what it says here is really, It's one of the many lullabies we have this evening. This is a German one, and it's saying, Mary rocks her child to sleep while the birds are singing. The nightingale actually is singing, sleep, baby, slumber softly. Maria sits am Rosenhag und wiegt ihr Jesus Kind. Durch die Bete leise weht der frohe Sonnenwind. Zu ihren Füßen singt ein our last set, the last piece of this set, may not need much of an introduction. It's the Italian Gesu Bambino, but we have a wonder. We have two composers that we are featuring this evening, and one of them is Jacqueline Hairston, who is actually the granddaughter of Chester Hairston. We'll speak a little bit more about her later. But this one is Mark Hayes, and I find that he has wonderful contemporary arrangements of well-loved carols. So here we go.
Exultation of It's Christmas Rose, it's King of Love and Light. Let every voice acclaim his name, the grateful chorus swell. From paradise to earth he came, that we with him might
was absolutely amazing. Thank you so much. And guess what? She'll be back. We're not letting you get off. Next up, we have a wonderful group called the Twylite Band. Whoops, am I getting feedback? Twylite Band is a subgroup of the Caribbean Diaspora Band based in Toronto and directed by Jeffery Ledger. And today, we have Jeffery Ledger, Stacey Little, and Newton Walker. Oh, there he is. Okay. And so please welcome to the stage, the Twylite Band.
Greetings, everyone. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas.
Right. Gonna share this song with you. I love this one. Your baby boy
Mary, did you know it's your baby boy that one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I am. The great I am. Mary, did you know? Shepherd in field that they lay in field where they keeping the sheep from a cold winter's night that was so deep. Nowhere born is a king of Israel. Nowhere, yeah. Born is the King of Israel. They looked right up and saw a star shine in the east, yeah, yeah. For, yeah, yeah, and they see right over the earth, this bright, bright light, follow where they are, yeah, nowhere, born is the King of Israel,
sound. You guys hang around too, eh? We'll hear you a bit more later on. Well, my gosh, what an exciting afternoon so far. I can see everybody bopping in their seats and having a good time and hearing lots of woos, which is always what you like to hear in church. But you know what I would like to hear right now in this church is the lovely Denise Williams coming back up and singing a few more beautiful songs for us. So well, welcome back, Denise Williams.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So here we go. We have another lovely lullaby. This is Dormi Jesu. It's a Chilean lullaby. And this lullaby is arranged by Jacqueline B. Hairston. That's the other composer we were chatting about. This is an African-American female composer. And she is granddaughter, very related. She's related in some way to Jester Hairston. Does anybody know maybe what Jester Hairston, he composed a carol. Actually, we're singing it a little later, so you need to check. In any case, we'll leave that for later. Dormi Jesu, it was sung by the, I'm just going to bring this a little closer here. Sung by the Araucanian Indians. And you know, the language was Latin, this lullaby. It's a lullaby, but it's a little faster. Spanish lullaby by Jose Ramon Gormisen Marquez. Oh, it's arranged by Marquez, so this is very good. We chose this because we love Marquez arrangements. And in this one, it's saying basically, sleep, baby Jesus, sleep, my little boy. And you will be blessed. The little spring is bubbling clear, the nightingale is singing in the forest, and everything will bless him. Some rhythm, yeah. We're going to have some rhythm on the drum. Yeah, the drum is there and the clavis are ready. Sorry. I forgot to add the rhythm section. So, yeah. Yeah. You're on here, too. Oh. I'm sorry. Rhythm. So can we just sort of start again one more time? Thank you. Here we go. I need the Spanish rhythm in there. Does anybody know Josh Groban? Okay, geez. Okay, well, we won't do the next piece. Just kidding. So, this one I think is made famous many times, but definitely Josh Groban has, I think, the most well looked at or watched or listened to version of Petit Papa Noël. This is new to me, and I've been doing some little research on some of the background of this song, and it's French. And I believe that it goes back quite a bit, but the meaning has changed over time. The way I look at this, it's saying essentially, Petit Papa Noël, the snow is raised and everything, but before closing your eyelids, we're going to say a small prayer. When you come down from the sky, this little boy or girl says, with thousands of toys, don't forget my little shoe. And don't forget to cover yourself well. Outside, you're going to be so cold. It's probably because of me that you're going to be cold, but I can't wait for the daybreak to see what you brought me. All the beautiful millions of toys that I see in my dreams and that I ordered from you, small Santa. When you come down from the sky with toys by the thousands, don't forget my little shoe. So I'm thinking toys and the dreams, but this person says, don't forget my little shoe. And what this reminds me of, it's, you know, we have different economic backgrounds in our country and in other countries. And I remember the first time we went down to Cuba, when I visited Cuba around this time of the year, and their idea of Christmas and gift giving is quite different. And the second time I went down, I was actually taking a lot of clothing and various things like that for people there who didn't have some of the basic needs, let's say, food and things like that. So for some reason, this begins to remind me of someone who's saying, I'm dreaming of thousands of toys, but don't forget my shoe, essentially. So it's very dear to my heart. If you know it, you can hum along. We're going to take this at a good pace. And I'm going to welcome at the last verse our little ensemble here at the back. Okay. As a matter of fact, my colleague Jeanette Roberts was going to be singing this, and she has a cold, so I'll be singing this for her today. C'est la belle lune, vie de Noël, a déchetant son manteau blanc, et les élèves vers le ciel, à genoux petit enfant, avant de fermer les papiers, font une dernière prière. Petit Papa Noël, quand tu descendras,
thank you.
absolutely lovely. I actually grew up in Quebec.
Oh.
And that was a song we heard every year. You couldn't go Christmas. That was, you'd hear it in the shopping malls, playing on Muzak. It was everywhere. So it brings back some wonderful memories for me. Of course, our Santa Claus is in Quebec. As a kid, I could never understand why Santa at the mall spoke with a thick French accent and smelled like jetem, but just part of living in a different culture. As you all know, this afternoon is not just about having some beautiful music from these absolutely amazing artists up here. It's also about doing a bit of fundraising, and we have two wonderful, worthwhile charities that the money we raise this afternoon are going to help support. And to tell us a little bit about this, we have a wonderful guest speaker this afternoon. And you may know the Most Reverend Frederick James Hiltz, who served as the 13th primate of the Anglican Church of Canada from 2007 to 2019. In January 2008, he became the first primate to be elected president of the board for Primates World Relief and Development Fund. And their funds is one of the two that we are raising money for today. This year, actually, he was bestowed the title of Honorary Associate, so many congratulations. He is also the co-chair for the Home for the Heart campaign of the Sisterhood of St. John the Divine, which is the other charity we're raising money for today. So to give us a little talk today and say hello to all of you here, please welcome up the Most Reverend Frederick James Hiltz.
Well, what a great joy to be with you this afternoon as we enjoy such great music of the season. I think we should just give a round of applause already. I can't see a lot of what's going on behind me because I'm in the second row, but it's pretty hard to stay still, isn't it? When you hear some of the kind of music that we're hearing this afternoon, it's just delightful. I want to say a special word of thanks to the Reverend Canon Stephen Kierkegaard and this parish of Holy Trinity Guildwood for designating proceeds from this Christmas concert to the Primate World Relief and Development Fund and for the renewal of the guest hosts of the Sisterhood of St. John the Divine. The one charity is in many respects dedicated to peace for God's children around the world. Children of every race, every language, every culture, children born and touched with the dignity of God. And the other is very much about peace within. Peace deep in our hearts that enables us to live a joyful life. So I'll say just a bit about each. As many of you know, the Primates World Relief and Development Fund is the Anglican Church of Canada's official agency for ending hunger, empowering gender equality, promoting Indigenous health, accompanying refugees, responding to environmental crises, and emergency response in the aftermath of natural disasters and in the very midst of conflict and war. PWRDF has always worked on a principle of partnership, partners on the ground who know and name for us the most urgent needs for support. as the Israel-Hamas war goes on, rages on. The world is witnessing one of history's most worst humanitarian catastrophes. The situation in Gaza is heartbreaking. Corridors for humanitarian aid are desperately needed, and they can only open and remain open as calls for ceasefire are heeded. And except for but a few brief days, the conflict rages on and on and on. Thousands upon thousands have died. Thousands upon thousands upon thousands seriously injured. The Archbishop of Canterbury, Justin Welby, recently said, and I quote, "The bloodshed, slaughter, and suffering of people on all sides must stop. What we know is that this violence will not secure for the peoples of the Holy Land what they deserve." What is especially appalling is the bombing of hospitals and health clinics designated by international humanitarian law as places of sanctuary for people in crisis. One such hospital in Gaza City, is the Ali Arab Hospital in Gaza, operated by the Anglican Diocese of Jerusalem. It serves the needs of all Gazans, irrespective of their faith traditions. Its doors have always been open to all. Having visited that hospital a couple of times throughout my ministry, I was deeply humbled by the care of its medical staff and their devotion to honoring the dignity of every child, man, and woman who come through its gates seeking medical attention. On October the 24th, that hospital was struck with the bombs, resulting in massive damage to its infrastructure, including its departments for ultrasound mammography, its diagnostic center, and its operating theater, its administrative office, and its entrance. Massive destruction. Within days, the Primate World Relief and Development Fund launched a Gaza hospital emergency appeal with an initial gift of $30,000. And wide support of this appeal continues to be generous across the country. And PWRDF will continue working with the Diocese of Jerusalem and other partners to ensure that funds raised will be used in the most effective way to be able to reopen and, we pray in time, rebuild that hospital. Thank you for your support this afternoon. Now I'll say just a little bit about the Home for the Heart campaign launched by the Sisterhood of St. John the Divine. This is what we call a homegrown Canadian Anglican religious order, founded here in Toronto in 1884 and celebrating next year its 140th anniversary. We're blessed this afternoon to have in our midst the Reverend Mother, Sister Elizabeth Rolfe Thomas, and also Sister Constance Joanna, who had also at one time been a Reverend Mother for the community, and she is co-chair for our capital campaign. Sitting between them is Judith Milne, and she is a companion in residence with the community of sisters for this year. I said to the sisters this afternoon, they brought along a chaperone to make sure they would be well behaved and represent the community well. I also want to say that all the sisters back at the convent are enjoying this concert online. And so, hello, sisters. I hope you're having a great time. Devoted to a life of prayer and good works in the service of the gospel, one of the sisters' principal ministries is monastic hospitality, welcoming many, many people, and in the name of Christ, treating them with all the courtesy of love. Some people come to the convent for rest and refreshment, a time apart from the busyness of the world, the crazy pace we all keep, a time to enjoy silence in the presence of God. Others come to read, research, and write. Some come for healing as they journey through very difficult circumstances in their lives, as they journey perhaps through an illness or a grief. Some come just to be carried in the sisters' daily round of prayer, where they lift up before God several times a day the needs of the church, the needs of our community, this city, and the world. They lift life heavenward. Many come to the convent discerning God's call in their lives. There's some kind of stirring, and they need to be able to take some time to discern what that's all about. Many come for quiet days and retreats, and the sisters welcome them all, people of all denominations, people of multiple faith traditions, and people of no faith. Those doors are open to everyone. And all who come speak of the quiet of the convent and of the peace that wraps her arms around them and nourishes them throughout their stay. It is the guests themselves who have given the guest hosts the title, A Home for the Heart. The convent on Comer Avenue is right next to St. John's Rehab Hospital. And it was originally founded by the sisters in 1936. Now it's, of course, part of the Sunnybrook Health Sciences Center. But the sisters still exercise a ministry of pastoral care in the hospital, and they very often welcome families of patients who are in long-term care in the rehab hospital. The guest house itself is a 70-year-old building. It's in need of major capital repairs, including a new roof, new HVAC system, new windows, and greater accessibility throughout. And for the comfort of their guests, the sisters want to upgrade the bedrooms and meeting rooms, enhancing the privacy of their guests. Principles of efficiency, environmental friendliness, spaciousness, and monastic simplicity are guiding principles for how this work will be carried out. The Home for the Heart campaign has a $6 million goal, and donations and pledges to date have totaled $4.6 million. Right now, we need $150,000 to get to $4.8 million so that we can go to tender and begin work early in the new year. As co-chair with Sister Constance Joanna, I thank you for your generous support. In these days, and throughout the 12 days of Christmas, we shall sing of him of whom Scripture says, to us a child is born, to us a son is given. The one of whom Scripture names as Prince of Peace. I don't know about you, but I can tell you that this Christmas, prayer for peace is all over my heart. Prayer for peace in war-torn countries, particularly Sudan, and the terrible crisis of hunger that looms so large there. The Holy Land. Peace among nations. Peace in our communities, that they might be free of gun violence. Peace in our homes. And peace in our hearts. May the peace of the Christ child be yours to receive and yours to share. I'm going to invite us all to stand up and exchange peace one with another. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Thank you very much for those inspiring words. And let's keep all that in mind as we are opening up our pocketbooks and purses and wallets this afternoon to help share what we have with these very, very worthwhile charities and so many people in such desperate need. Well, now we're in for a treat because we are going to hear Mr. Jan Morgan, who is a professional trumpet and trombone player. Now, Jan was born and raised in Guyana. And he worked for the Guyana Police Force and gained the rank of sergeant, which means, to me, you're probably the only brass player I know who can legally carry a taser.
He's hearing you.
Oh, he's up there. I thought he was there a minute ago.
He says, keep talking for a shot.
Okay, keep talking. All right, I'll tell you a bit more about him. Since moving here in 1994, he's been involved in playing and recording performances with many, many international artists. He's also the lead trumpet player for the Juno Award-winning band Kobotan. They've been nominated twice for the Juno Awards, and they won it in 2008 for World Music Album of the Year. Hello again. Just loading your gun up there for in case of trouble.
I went too far.
He's also played for some amazing artists, the late Percy Sledge, King Ajamo from Grenada, Anselm Douglas, Calypso, Rose from Trinidad and Tobago, South Asian movie actor and singer who appeared in the movie Slumdog Billionaire, Vijay Prakash, as well as the late Cuba Gooding Sr., oh bye, the legendary David Rudder from Trinidad and Tobago, and the great reggae icon Luciano from Jamaica. He's performed with and recorded with local Canadian bands like Aussie Gurley, and of course, his own band, Kobotown. And are we... I'll tell a story about when I was traveling with a trumpet player. Because he used to sit next to the sax player. Just a warning for you over there. He would sit next to the sax player. When the sax player would look away, my trumpet player would take things like orange peels or banana peels that he'd been snacking on, and he would shove the peel in the bell of the sax. And then we would wait and see how many songs he had to play before the sax player realized something was wrong. I'm not suggesting you do that tonight. Because now I've given away. Are you ready? All right. Okay, then I am proud to welcome Mr. Jan Morgan.
Check, check. We good?
It's just too much fabulous music up here today, I tell you. Now, what would you say if I told you we have heard Denise Williams? We have heard Denise Williams and her ensemble. We have heard the Twylite Band. What would you say if I told you you could hear them all together? Would we do applaud for that? Well, I think that's what we're going to hear right now. So let's bring back up Denise Williams, your ensemble, and the Twylite Band. Wherever they are. Okay, come on back up.
I, Noel Ragney and Gloria Shane. And you might know that in the, I guess it was sort of around the 50s, 60s, and 70s, a lot of contemporary music, Christmas music, was composed by people who were of a different faith, namely Jewish people. So it's really nice to find such richness at this time of the year and celebrating in various ways. All right, so we have it. Let's go.
Said the night wind to the little lamb, "Do you see what I see?
Do you see what I see?
Way up in the sky, little lamb. Do you see what I see?
Do you see what I see?
A star dancing in the night with a tail as big as a kite. With a tail as big as a kite." Said the little lamb to the shepherd boy, "Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
Ringing through the sky, shepherd boy. Do you hear what I hear?
Do you hear what I hear?
A song high above the trees, with a voice as big as the sea. With a voice as big as the sea." Said the shepherd boy to the mighty king,
sit too soon, because I think the Virgin Mary, this is where we may get some of you helping too. The Virgin Mary had a baby boy. Now this one is, this was arranged, not arranged by Jacqueline Harrison nor Marques. It's in your book, your booklets. But this particular, it's a Caribbean traditional. But this particular arrangement that I liked employed sort of some canons, some other people. Join whenever you'd like to join. And we welcome the Virgin Mary had a baby boy. Let's swing. We can swing too, eh?
The Virgin Mary had a baby boy. The Virgin Mary had a baby boy. The Virgin Mary had a baby boy. And they say that his name was Jesus.
There'll be some dancing here, okay?
He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer. Oh yes, believer.
come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Here we go, y'all. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer. Oh yes, believer. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Now we are going to add those shepherds. The shepherds. You gonna do you know the shepherds verse?
Why?
The shepherd. The shepherds came when the baby born. Okay, here we go. I'm with you. I got you. The shepherds came when the baby born. Okay, ready? You see it here? Ready? The shepherds came when the baby born. The shepherds came when the baby born. From the glory, he come from the glorious kingdom. Oh yes, believer. Oh yes, believer. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Now I'm hearing a lot of singing, which I really like, but I think I could probably hear a bit more singing and a bit more movement. Right, 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 right. More singing, more movement. So this is like the wise men now, okay? Here we go, the wise men. The wise men saw where the baby born. The wise men saw where the baby born. The wise men saw where the baby born. And they say that his name was
Jesus.
That was it. Oh, we're gonna. He come from the glory. Our last chance, everybody. Be very good. He come from the glorious kingdom. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. Oh, yes, believer. Oh, yes, believer. He come from the glory. He come from the glorious kingdom. He come from, he come from, he come from the glorious kingdom. He come from, he come from, he come from the glorious kingdom. He come from, he come from, he come from the glorious kingdom. He come from. Okay, nice to see you up on your feet. We have another one for you. So this is Jester's. Jester who, bud? Jester who?
Hairston.
Jester Hairston, yes. This is related to our Jacqueline B. Hairston. Look them up. You know, you can check things on YouTube these days. You just sort of go up and think, Jacqueline Hairston, Justin Hairston. So this one is Mary's Boy Child. Does anybody know this one? Well, okay. So we're going to do the same thing. Catch your breath. And we're going to do the same thing. We have some solos here today. We have the men. We have Peter in your choir. And we have Flo in your choir.
So listen out for these lovely solo voices, and you can sing along too. Why not? We're singing Hark Now Hear the Angels Sing as the refrain. A new king born today, and man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. And the very last time, we're singing Hark Now Hear the Angels Sing, but then we're adding another refrain, which is called Trumpets Sound and Angels Sing. I think you kind of can figure it out. Okay, let's do it. Oh yeah, there's a trumpet here. Where are you laughing? Yeah, this, you, yeah, I don't know. We just may hear the trumpet. If we sing loud enough, he'll play. Okay. Okay, here we go. Mary's Boy Child.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible say, Mary's Boy Child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, new king born.
The Virgin Mary had a baby boy that Sweet Carol. Yes. So I'm having a seat and come back up and announce the next number. Thank you.
Well, and I'm sorry, I brought the Twylite Band up a little early. Yeah, so yeah, I just, that's what happened. So. There were, I know, I saw it. So like, I was one third right. So please welcome back to the stage where they've been for the last few minutes, the fabulous Twylite Band.
All right, so I'm gonna share a song with you because I'm a Caribbean girl. I'm from the island of St. Vincent and the Grenadines. And Newton, you're Jamaican?
Mm-hmm.
Right, so we're from the Caribbean. I'm just gonna share this song and hope you enjoy it.
Okay.
It's gonna be a little different.
Should I play drum, baby?
All right?
Okay.
He causes you to move. I wonder what you're thinking, and I wonder how you're feeling. The Christmas breeze outside it blowing, and in the air we have this feeling. A feeling of love, a feeling of peace, feeling to share, feeling to greet, a feeling to sing. So we bring in, we bring in, we bring in, we bring in sweet carol, sweet carolin, sweet carol, sweet carolin, sweet carol, sweet carolin, sweet carol, sweet carolin,
sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol,
sweet carol,
sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol.
We have all the ingredients for the cake, the fruit on set. Man, everything is in the kitchen. Eating up nothing we forget. We cream and we butter, beating we eggs, chewing we spice, sifting we flour, folding it nice. We add it, we add it, we add it, we add it.
Sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol. Sweet carol, 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 sweet carol.
The sweetest carol for Christmas is Jesus Christ, my Savior, and he's the reason for the season. Yes, he's a blessed Redeemer. Sweetest note in Sarah's song, sweetest name on mortal tongue, sweetest carol that ever sung. Me Jesus, sweet.
Sweet carol.
Me Jesus, sweet.
Sweet carol. Sweet carol.
Sweet carol. Me Jesus, sweet. Me Jesus, me Jesus, sweet. Can you sing with me? Sing sweet. Sweet carol,
sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol,
sweet carol, sweet carol, sweet carol. That was just a little bit different, a taste of the Caribbean for you. And this song is classic one in the contemporary. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. So I'm wishing you a merry little Christmas from us, Twylite. And it's good to be here today. You know how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It's my first time here. You know, sometimes you're a little bit, you know, when you're in a place for the first time, so I'm trying to hide my little self in plain sight. All right? But this one, I want to share it with you. Thank you. just hold the person's hands next to you.
Through the years, we all will be together. If the faith allows, hang a shining star upon the highest bough, and help yourselves a merry yourselves a merry little, to the guys in the back, have yourselves a merry, to the guys up top, have yourselves a merry, and the last one, everyone here, so have yourselves a merry.
One more hand for the Twylite Band. Oh my God. Keep an eye out for these people. I tell you, they're really going to be something once Stacey finally comes out of her shell. But excellent mic technique, by the way. I was watching that. Well, you know what? I think we need to hear this side of the stage now. All once right. more. You ready to sing us a few more, Denise?
Of course.
Okay. Please welcome back Denise Williams.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. That was absolutely amazing. Amazing singing and, yes, mic technique and all of that. Now, when I hear myself back in the mic, it just drives me a little crazy. Just to say. Different thing. So is this mic hot for me or just for the live stream? Good. Yeah, I don't need it that hot. Because I'm going to heat things up a bit, that's all. That's what I have to say. So why I'm going to heat things up a bit is that I'm going to sing some spirituals for you now, some Christmas spirituals, and I love the spirituals. This one is a combination of a few different spirituals, a medley, and Jacqueline B. Hairston is our arranger, and she arranged these for Kathleen Battle. Does anybody maybe not know Kathleen Battle? American, African-American, wonderful opera and classical singer. So, Mary and Her Baby.
Reading the Gospel of Gospel of Luke and John, reading the gospel and hear the news, how the little boy child was born. Read about Mary and Joseph, come a riding on a donkey from far, slept in a stable at Bethlehem, where the shepherds all seen
Okay, we are going out with two more spirituals, and just like spirituals, we invite you to sing the refrain if you can, if you pick it up, sing the refrain. I know the choir may sing the refrain. This one is called Behold That Star, arranged by you know who, Mark Hayes. Get away, you guys. I just have to get away. I had to leave. Okay, here's another one. Last one before we go out. We're going out. I think I'm doing another one right now. Yeah. It is called, do you know Rise Up Shepherd and Follow? Heard of that a little bit? And Go Tell It on the Mountain. How could it be our season without a Go Tell It on the Mountain over the hills that Jesus Christ is born? So this is a medley arranged by, you guessed it, Marcus. All right, so let's get this done.
Go tell it on the mountain. Go tell it in the valleys. Go tell Jesus, yes, Jesus Christ is born. There's a star in the east on Christmas morn. Rise up, shepherd, and follow. It'll lead to the place where the Christ was born. Shepherd and follow, follow. shepherd and follow the star of Bethlehem. Rise up, shepherd, rise up, shepherd, rise up, shepherd, and follow.
Did I get that right?
Okay, we're going to quieten down a little bit, sort of like the second last high note there I have tonight. But anyway, well, we have our instrumentalists. So are we, I'm not looking at my program, so. Let me just make sure that I'm not taking you away from anything, because we're about to sing Jesse's Carol. Okay, then, great. We're about to sing Jesse's Carol. It's called This Christmastide. And this was... did you say that this was we think it's a Canadian composer, but it was
from Charlottetown.
This was composed for Jesse Norman. Does that name sound familiar?
Yeah.
Beautiful song. So we'll take it through. We invite the two instrumentalists and the ensemble again.
Thank you.
lovely music, I can't tell you. I have to give it one more round of applause for all the performers up here on the stage. I'd like to say a very special thank you to all the performers here today. Denise Williams, of course, Jan Morgan on trumpet, Ben MacDonald, David Smith on piano, Alexandra Weiss, of course, over at the piano, because these are all your friends. And the Twylite Band, of course, with Newton Walker, Jeffery Ledger, and Stacey Little. I'd also like to say a special thank you to Denise Byard right here at Holy Trinity for helping put this whole program together. So thank you, Denise. She's always the one running around doing 10 things at a time, so that's probably no Denise. And so just to round, oh, and I should have mentioned earlier on, and I apologize, Douglas Van Edelman, who was supposed to be here, could not be with us today, unfortunately, because he was taken ill. He's quite ill at home with a cold, and he just was not up to coming and singing here today and making this a super spreader. So we send him his best wishes, and but I think you'll agree with me, we had show and a half up here today. Thank you all so much. Now I'd like to welcome up to the stage a man I'm sure some of you here know, if not all of you, my very good friend, the Reverend Canon Stephen Kierkegaard.
Short but sweet. I wish this night could just continue. Every once in a while, it's just magical, marvelous music. And that's what we have had tonight. To our performers, just outstanding. Thank you so, so much. We had some laughter, some dancing, song, and for the romantics, even some tears. So it was just a fabulous night. I want to thank Archbishop Fred for his inspirational words. This is a benefit concert for peace, to foster peace here at home, in our hearts, and around the world. In gratitude for the Prince of Peace born on Christmas Day. Thank you for your compassion. Your donations today will go internationally to aid the victims of war through the humanitarian work of PWRDF, particularly for the intense needs in Gaza, as well as in the West Bank and Israel. And then, sadly, through war, we have a terrible crisis of hunger in the South Sudan. And locally, to the Home for the Heart campaign of the Sisterhood of St. John the Divine, to best create an oasis of hospitality and peace right here in our own city of Toronto. May your generosity assist the growth of peace at home, in our city, and around the world. At the back of the church and in the foyer, or in churchland language, the narthex, you can donate by tap, cash, or check. Or you can donate if you're online via our website, and the QR code is probably showing on the screen. If you're here in person, the QR code is right on the front of your program or bulletin. Thank you for your kindness and helping make the world a better, more peaceful place. I see Robbie Rhodes, who's our award for the Order of the Diocese of Toronto. We had an earlier campaign this year from our most faithful donors, and I guess I should also get the basket out. I'll get that. This is 92 years. Yeah. She's about to leave for Vienna tomorrow on an airplane. Eva McLean would meet her at the door. I want to thank our AV crew, and I didn't know that our AV crew were also professional dancers, so you are now hired. When St. Nick was here earlier this month, there was a rumor that this church will actually be open for Christmas. So, of course, we would love to see you Christmas Eve at 7:30 or Christmas Day at 10:30 a.m. We just love to continue to celebrate Christmas and the season with you. Lastly, people have been ad-libbing all over the place, so Fred, you didn't know this, but come on up here, please. I'm sure we can both ad-lib this together. I'm in sales, he's in management.
I'm supposed to be retired.
So I thought we'd just close with a prayer, and then we'll have a last hymn, of course. We'll close for a prayer for peace, which is so badly needed right now in the world today, and then a blessing and a song. Many of you will know this prayer. It's famous. It's the words of St. Francis. Let us pray. Lord, make us instruments of your peace. Where there is hatred, let us sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. And where there is sadness, joy. O Divine Master, grant that we may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. May the eagerness of the shepherds, the joy of the angels, the love of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Prince of Peace be yours this Christmas.
Amen. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this Christmastide. Amen.
Last hymn.
So, we're singing O Holy Night. I think we should, dare I say, shall we stand? Yeah. You guessed it. This is, oops, my glasses. This is Adolph Adam, there we go. Arranged by, yeah, you got it. Okay, I can see sort of here. Okay, here we go. Take it away. I know this.
Stars are brightly shining. It is the night.
Coming. Wow, what a night. Wow, there's no other words I have. And this Denise has been wow. Wow. Like, a fundraiser, and part of the joy is we get to help others. So if you can share on your socials, because it will be up on our, it is on our YouTube even now. So those of us who are, you who are watching, please share. When you go home, please share, and it will be up. And we still have a few days, a few weeks before the end of the month, and definitely the PWRDF and the sisters and the convent would definitely appreciate all the help that you can give. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.